guidelines. Today we'll see the guidelines also present on the inferior surface of the cerebrum. This is the midbrain. And this is the cerebral aqueduct. This is the optic chiasma. This is the tuber cinerum, two mammillary bodies. And this is the posterior perforated substance. This is the olfactory sulcus. Here there is the anterior perforated substance. This is the inferior surface of the cerebrum. And first, this inferior surface of the cerebrum is divided into two parts by means of a lateral stem of lateral sulcus. This is the stem of lateral sulcus. And here we'll see the anterior perforated substance. This stem of lateral sulcus will divide into anterior orbital part, posterior tentorial part. Now we'll see the sulci and gyri present on the anterior orbital part. First one is the olfactory sulcus. This is the striate sulcus, which runs from anterior to the posterior, which is nearer to the median inferomedial border of inferior orbital surface. This is the inferomedial border and this is the inferolateral border. So if you see, this is the brain. At the brain, there is the superolateral surface and this is the medial surface and this one is the inferior surface. Superolateral, medial, superolateral and inferior surface. Borders are superomedial border, top one is exactly parallel to this one. There is, at the top there is another border, that is the superomedial border and this is the inferomedial border, this one, and this is the inferolateral border. This is the first sulci which are seen in the orbital surface, is known as the olfactory sulcus, which runs from anterior to the posterior in direction and nearer to the medial border of orbital surface, inferomedial border of orbital surface. By the presence of this sulcus, we'll see here a gyrus known as the olfactory tract with olfactory bulb. There is an olfactory bulb and olfactory tract. This one is the olfactory tract and this one is the olfactory bulb. This is the center for olfaction. This is the olfactory sulcus. This is the olfactory sulcus. There is another irregular H-shaped sulcus that is known as the orbital sulci, which divides the area into medial, lateral, anterior, posterior, orbital gyri. All these are the orbital gyri. Anterior orbital, posterior orbital, medial lateral orbital gyri, and this is the orbital sulci, H-shaped orbital sulci. Now we will see the sulci and gyri seen on the tentorial part. Mainly there are two sulci. One is collateral sulcus. This is the collateral sulcus. And this is the occipitotemporal sulcus. This is the occipital part and this is the temporal part. Occipitotemporal sulcus, this one. Occipitotemporal sulcus. This is the Sjögren sulcus. And this is the post-Sjögren sulcus. And this is the lunate sulcus. So, this is the collateral sulcus. Collateral sulcus. Here, this collateral sulcus, which runs parallel in the same direction of the calcarine sulcus. So, the area between the these two sulcus, this total, this is the collateral sulcus and this is the calcarine sulcus. Here at this point, this collateral sulcus will runs exactly parallel to the direction of the calcranial sulcus. So, the area present between these two sulcus is known as the lingual gyrus. Lingual gyrus. Anteriorly, this is the lingual gyrus. Anteriorly, this lingual gyrus will continues as the parahippocampal gyrus. Parahippocampal gyrus. At this point, anteriorly, this parahippocampal gyrus will turn, will hook backwards medially. At this point, this bulged part is known as uncus. This parahippocampal gyrus, at its anterior end, it hooks backwards medially. At this point, this parahippocampal gyrus, it is known as the uncus. Lateral to the uncus, it is limited by another sulcus known as rhinal sulcus. This is the rhinal sulcus. So, this is the uncus and this is the rhinal sulcus. This is the collateral sulcus, calcarine sulcus, lingual gyrus, parahippocampal gyrus. So, now we will see the area which is seen between the gyrus seen in this area. The gyrus present in between these two areas. Here, what are the areas means medially, this area is limited by the collateral sulcus, laterally by the occipitotemporal sulcus. This area is known as medial occipitotemporal gyrus. And the area which is limited by the area which is seen laterally towards the occipitotemporal sulcus is known as lateral occipitotemporal gyrus. So, these are the sulci and gyri present on the inferior surface on the tentorial part. This is the lateral occipitotemporal gyrus. This is the medial occipitotemporal gyrus. Here we will see the parahippocampal gyrus. This parahippocampal gyrus, at its anterior end, it hooks backwards and medially. At that part, it is known as uncus. And this at this uncus, it is limited by the rhinal sulcus. Now, here we will see the post-calcarine sulcus and this is the lunate sulcus. Now, we will see another point. This lateral occipitotemporal gyrus will continues at the inferolateral margin, and it continues with the cipralateral surface and continues with the inferior temporal gyrus. This lateral occipitotemporal gyrus will continues with the inferior temporal gyrus by passing through the superolateral surface. Here, this uncus, this parahippocampal gyrus, at its posteriorly, it continues with the cingulate gyrus through the isthmus. On the medial surface, we'll see the cingulate gyrus. Cingulate gyrus just above the corpus callosum, we'll see cingulate sulcus, and the area between those two is known as cingulate gyrus. This uncus will continue posteriorly through the isthmus with the cingulate gyrus. So these are the sulci and gyri which are seen on the inferior surface of the cerebrum.